Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're starting a new series within the 30 Days of Code series, and it is going to be a bonus video series. And so each 10th day of the 30 Days of Code is going to be a bonus video. And so what does that mean? Well, it's going to be something that you could skip all the other videos and still understand it. It's self-contained, meaning anything that you learn in this video, you don't need any programming experience for, and we probably won't use it again within the 30 days. But it's something that you've seen out in the world and you've been like, oh, that's computer science. Oh, that looks hard. I don't want to do that. Well, today you're actually going to learn it. And so what are we going to do? Binary. You've been seeing these ones and zeros on my screen, and now you're going to actually find out what they mean. And so you may have seen like a meme or a sign or something, and this is the famous saying about binary, and you read it like this. You read it like, there are only 10 types of people in the world, those who understand binary and those who don't. You read that as 10. But it really means two, and you're gonna understand this, and today you're gonna transition from someone that doesn't know binary to someone that does, and it will be magical, it will be wonderful, you're gonna understand, you're gonna be enlightened, and you're gonna understand what the hell all of those ones and zeros mean. And so, here we go. Before we start talking about binary, first we have to talk about Booleans. Booleans, what are they? Well, if you haven't looked at the other videos, basically they're true or false values, and so it's a value, it can either be true or false, a one or a zero. So we could say, the sky is blue, that's true, one. The grass is pink, that's false, zero. You can also think of it as like an on-off switch. If the light is on, it's a true value, or the light is off, it's false, it's a zero value. What does this have to do with ones and zeros? We'll get there, but first think of how we represent numbers in everyday life. A single digit goes from 0 to 9, and all of our numbers from 90 to 37 to 2, they're all in base 10. Meaning you have a number times 10 to the 0th, then a number times 10 to the 1st, then a number times 10 to the 2nd, then you add them all together, and that's how you get your final number. So what does base 10 really mean? Well, as an adult, you look at numbers like numbers. You see 10, it means 10. You see 20, you think $20. That's, I can go to a movie or something. You probably can't go to a movie because they're expensive now, but like you yourself could get, you know, yourself into the movie theater. But you see these numbers as just numbers, values. But do you remember a time where you didn't know that? Where you didn't know, oh, 20 means 20. What the hell, you know, what is this? They're just numbers. Think back to elementary school. In elementary school, you looked at a number, say, 723. You put 3 blocks in the ones column, you put 2 bigger blocks in the tens column, and then you put 7 huge blocks in the hundreds column, and that's how you kind of came up with 723. You didn't really know what it meant yet, you just know there was a ones, tens, and hundreds column, and you just put things in there, and that's how you got your numbers. Kind of remember? Well, what you were really doing for the number 723 is that you were getting your ones by doing 3 times 10 to the 0th power, which 10 to the 0th is 1, so you were just doing 3, plus 2, which was in the tens column, 2 times 10 to the 1st, 2 times 10 equals 20, so you did 20 plus 3, and then you had the 7, and you did the 7 times 10 to the 2nd, which was 7 times 100, which gave you 700, and then you added 720 and 3 to then end up getting 723. So what do all these bases have to do with anything? Why are we even thinking about our numbers? Well, think of this formula. You have A, which is a number from 0 to the base minus 1, so that was like our 7, our 2, our 3, our digit value. Then we had that times our B, base, which was 10, and then D was the numerical digit location with the location starting at 0. So we had 3 times 10 to the 0th because it was at the 0th location and the value that we wanted there was 3. Then we had 2 times 10 to the 1st, that was the first location inside of like, it was the 10th, so it was the 1st, you know, starting at 0, 0 was 1s, 10th was 1. So we had 10 to the 1st, then the value that we had there was 2. That was the number that was between 0 and the base minus 1, 0 to 9. And then we had 7 times 10 to the 2nd, where 7 was the value represented there, and then we had times 10, the base, to the 2nd power, because it was the 2nd within the numerical listing. I promise this will all make sense. This is a lot of math right now. Just kind of let it sink in. Like, how do I even remember numbers? Well, in binary, we are working with a different base. We're working with base 2, where the digits are 0 and 1. And to come up with numbers, we do like a value times the base to a certain power. So we can look at a simple example and try to see a pattern. Take the number 7. So how would we get 7 in binary? Well, if we take our basic blocks from the formula we had earlier, we have this base, 2, and we do 2 to the 0th, 2 to the 1th, 2 to the 2th, to like get with different digits within our base 2. And so how would we get 7? Well, 7 is comprised of 4, 2, and 1. And each of those can be made up of a base 2 combination. And so if we just look at this binary number and break it down, I think it'll be a lot easier. So 7 is 111 in binary. What does that mean? Well, for the first one, it was 1 times 2 to the 0th. And 2 to the 0th is 1. And so we have 1 plus 1 times 2 to the 1st. 2 to the 1st is 2. So we have 1 times 2 equals 2. So we have 1 plus 2, that's 3. And then we get our 4 by doing 1 times 2 to the 2th, we get 4. It's important to remember that any number that we get in base 10, we can turn into base 2. And any number that we get in base 2, we can turn into base 10. They may have different numbers of digits, but they all can be represented in accordance with each other. And so let's do some examples to try to wrap our heads around the fact that you can do like 0 or 1 times 2 to a certain power to get a number and then have a bunch of those summed up to then get your final answer that's a numerical number. So, some examples. We'll start off with our numbers in base 2 and try to convert them to base 10. Take the number 1. Well, 1 is really 1 times 2 to the 0th, which equals 1. So 1 is 1 in binary and in base 10. Let's take the number 11. Well, if we take it apart, the first one represents 1 times 2 to the 0th, and the second one represents 1 times 2 to the 1st. What is that summed up? Well, 1 times 2 to the 0th is just 1, so 1 plus 1 times 2 to the 1st, 2. So 2 plus 1 equals 3. Kind of makes sense? Let's take the number 101. Okay, in the first place, we have 1 times 2 to the 0th, which we know is 1. Then we have 0 times 2 to the 1st, so that's nothing, so we still have 1. Then in the next position, we have 1 times 2 to the 2nd, 4. Okay, so then we have 4 plus 1 equals 5. Now let's take the number 1110. Okay, well that's 0 times 2 to the 0th, 0. 1 times 2 to the 1st, 2. Okay, so 2 plus 1 times 2 to the 2nd, 4. Okay, 2 plus 4, that's 6. Now the last one, 1 times 2 to the 3rd, okay, 8. So now we have 2 plus 4 plus 8, which equals 14. So 1110 equals 14. Okay, what if we added 1 to that? What if we made it 1111? Well, that would be the same thing as having the 14 already there, plus 1, 15. So 1111 is just 15 because it's 1110 plus 1. Kind of clicking, kind of makes sense. And if we do the math the usual way, we'll have 1 times 2 to the 0th, which will be 1. 1 times 2 to the 1st, which will be 2, and it'll get all summed up like before, and it'll equal 15. And looking at this chart, we can see that each 1 represents like a certain power of 3. So the first one is like 2 to the 0th, so it's just like adding 1. And then the second position is like 2 to the 1st, which is like adding 2. And then the third position is like 2 to the 2nd, which is like adding 4. Then 2 to the 3rd, that's 8. 2 to the 4th, that would be the next position. 2 to the 5th, until you keep going on and on forever. So what happens if you have something like 16 or 8? Well, you would just have 1 in that position because 2 to the 3rd is 8. And so we'd have 1 and then 0, 0, 0 in the other three positions because you don't need any other elements. You can just do the 1, which will count for 2 to the 3rd to get 8. So if you ever have a pattern like that, it's just going to be a 1 and then zeros for the rest of the way down, where it's a number that can equal 2 to the A of that something, and then whatever that A is, say it's the 5th position, well then the 5th will be a 1 and then everything before that will be zeros. What if we have an example that's like 0110? Well, we'd have 0, so it's 0, then we'd have 1, which would be 2 to the 1st, which would be 2, plus then 2 to the 2nd, 4, so 2 plus 4 equals 6. What about leading zeros? Well, they make no difference because 2 to the 3rd times 0 is still 0. And so the entire sum comes up to be 6. Thus, leading zeros do not matter here in binary. What if we want to convert from base 10 to base 2? Say I have the number 34, 57, you know, it's out there. It's a number. We want to know, okay, what is it in binary? What is it in ones and zeros? I see that number out there. What is it in computer binariness? Well, this one's a little bit more complicated than the other one. I know, scary. Don't worry, we got this. Say, for example, you have the number 34. How do you figure it out? Well, to go from 34 to binary, we do a lot of division. So stay with me on this, it's gonna be a little weird. You're gonna do 34 divided by 2, you'll get 17. The remainder of that will be 0, so that will be something we keep track of We'll have a 0 written down. Then we'll have 17 divided by 2 equals 8. Then we have the remainder 1, so we keep track of our 0 and 1. Then we have that 8 that we just got from the other thing. We have 8 divided by 2 again. We get 4, remainder 0. So now we have 0, 1, 0, kept track. Then we have 4 divided by 2. Then we get remainder 0. Again, keep track of that 0. So now we have 0, 1, 0, 0 left. Then we take that 2 divided by 2. We get 1, remainder 0. So now we have 0, 1, 0, 0, 0. Then we take that 1 divided by 2. We get 0, remainder 1. And then we keep track of that last one. And so how does this equal a binary number? Well, we take the last number that we got, and that is really the front of the number. So we kind of loop them all together. So then we have the number 100010. And that will equal 34. And you can use the previous method before from converting base 2 to base 10 to make sure it works. And so we have something in the first position, which is 2 to the first, which equals 2. So you'd have 2 plus. And then we have something in the fifth position, so 2 to the fifth is 32, and then 32 plus 2 equals 34, so we do in fact have the right number. And now you know how to convert from base 2 to base 10, and then base 10 back to base 2. Here's a list of the common ones you should probably know. Knowing the numbers 0 to 15 is pretty good. You're a good binator. You know, if you know those by heart, you can usually convert very easily from base 2 to base 10. If you know these main ones, and then you can just, you know, do the usual method if you don't know exactly what it is on point. So now that we know how to do conversion, what else can we do with these numbers? Well, you can do operations on them. Those things are like addition. So in addition, we have 0 plus 0 equals 0, 1 plus 0 equals 1, 0 plus 1 equals 1. Okay, big case here, 1 plus 1 actually equals 0 because there's no 2 in this language of base 2. In base 10, we don't have a digit called 10. We just have 0 to 9, and then you would like carry one over if you get past 9. Same thing here. If you have 1 plus 1, then that's going to equal 0 because we have like a carry out that is then carried over to the next digit. So let's do some examples and try to wrap our heads around this. And so we are going to do the example 6 plus 7, which in binary, if you want to pause the video now, try to figure it out, it's going to be 110 plus 111. And so going line by line, we'll do 0 plus 1 equals 1. 1 plus 1 is going to be 0, so we'll do the 0 and then the carry over, and then we'll have 1 plus 1 plus 1, which will equal 1, and then we'll have another carry, 1, and that will equal 13 if we do all the math, because we have a 1, which will be 1 plus, and then we have a 4 because we have something in the second slot, and then we'll have an 8 because we have something in the third slot, so we'll have 1 plus 4 plus 8 equals 13, and 6 plus 7 also equals 13. So we are good to go. In our next example, we are going to do 7 plus 7, which is going to be 111 plus 111, and we should get 14. So let's do it. We'll have 11, which will equal 0, carry the 1, then we'll have 111. It will equal 1, and then we'll carry the 1. 111 again, we'll get a 1, and then do another 1 to make up for the fact we had a carry out. And so it'll be 1110, which will be 2 plus 4 plus 8, which again equals 14. So we are good to go. And for our last example, we are going to do 5 plus 7. And so if you want to write those in binary before I tell you, and it's going to be 101 plus 111. And so you'll get 1 plus 1, which will 0, carry the 1, then we'll get 1 plus 1 again, 0, carry the 1, then we'll get 111. So then we do a 1 and then carry out the 1, but we're at the end, so then we just place it right there, and then we get 1100, which again equals 4 plus 8 because we have something in the second slot, and then we have something in the third slot, and so 2 to the second is 4, 2 to the third is 8, so we have 4 plus 8, 12, all is good. 5 plus 7 does equal 12, and those binary numbers work correctly. I would go through multiplication and division, but they're the same as base 10, so I won't go over them here. However, I'll put some links down below for some examples, but again, exactly the same as base 10. But inside of these operations, you have some additions, some subtractions, stuff like that, and they work exactly the same as our addition before. You can also, in binary, represent decimal numbers in scientific notation, but beyond the scope of this video. If you're interested in that type of stuff, comment down below and let me know. I can do a video on it, but again, kind of far out there for people that are just, you know, understanding what binary is. It needs a little break before, you know, you introduce crazy stuff. And so the last thing we're going to talk about today is something called 2's complement. And so if you think, Okay, we've been dealing with 5, 7, 6, 15, 24, 34, whatever. They've all been positive numbers. How do we represent negative numbers inside of binary? Well, we do two things. One, we have this 2's complement thing, which is the saying, flip the bits and add one, which will make more sense later. 2, we will represent this number as a single byte, so it'll have 8 numbers inside of it, 8 bits, and so that's considered a byte. 8 bits make up a byte, and a bit is like a single number. It's a single 1 or 0. And let's say we have the number 6. Well, the 6 is just 0, 1, 1, you know, that's it. That's 6. It's 3 little bits. What if we want to make it 8? Well, we have to do something called extending the sign. And so remember how I was saying leading zeros don't matter? Well, we take advantage of the fact here. If we have the number 110, which is 6, we can do from the back to the front, we could do 0110 and then do 0000 all the way down. And it would still equal 6. So let's just look at some examples. For the number 12, say, we're going to have 00110000. And that'll be 8 bits, 8 characters, 8 little numbers. There you go. And our sign is extended all the way out. How do we make this a negative number? How do we get negative 12? Well, we flip the bits and add 1. And so we flip the bits, and so now we'd have 11001111. And then we add 1, and so by adding 1, we have 1 plus 1, which equals 0, carry the 1. 1 plus 1 equals 0, carry the 1. Oh, we have 0 here, so we'll just have the 1. So our new number, which is going to actually equal negative 12, is going to be 00101111. There we go. That's negative 12, and we're done. And you can do the same thing to get your positive number back. So if I flip the bits, add 1, I will get 00110000 back. Let's do it with 5. 5 in binary would be 101000 all the way down to 8. Negative 5 after we flip the bits. Flipping the bits, it will be 01011111. And then adding 1, we'll get 1101s and then all the way down. Looking at 7, to get negative 7, well, we have to do flip the bits, add 1, plus extending the sign. And so for 7 in binary, in our 8-bit little thing that we're going to do, our 8-bit byte thing, we're going to have 111 and then zeros all the way down to get negative 7, flip the bits, so we'll get 000 and then 1's all the way down, add 1, we'll get 100 and then 1's all the way down. There you go. That's negative 7. We're done. And you can do this with any number as long as you allow yourself enough digits, you know, how you have a ones place, a tens place, a hundreds place, as long as you allow yourself enough bits, enough bytes to get across that number, you should be able to represent anything in here. But it must be, again, a finite number. There are only 2 types of people in the world, those who understand binary and those who don't. Notice the 0 would be like 0 times 2 to the 0th, which would be 0, plus 1 times 2 to the 1st, which would be 2, so then you have 2 plus 0. There are only 2 types of people in this world, not 10. You got this. You understand things now. We talked about binary. We talked about what it all means. We talked about how to convert from like base 2 binary to 10 and how to convert from like our normal numbers to base 2. We talked about addition, multiplication, division. You know, we talked about a lot of stuff and we talked about negative numbers. And so that's it for this video. The HackerRank Challenge is down below in the description. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment on this video. I hope you learned something and I will see you tomorrow.